still on the team, Willie, said he's under contract still. Our rookies played amazing. Denny and Cole Anthony. We still have the trade. Shake Milton, because I really like how Thibault played. He's a really great 3 and D player. An 8 3-point shot, A+ perimeter defender. Coming off the bench is amazing. So with that being said, I'm just going to go into the draft, see what we can do. I don't think we really have any picks, do we? We have the 23rd pick. Okay, so I might trade a future first in this pick, see if I can move up, make any moves, maybe. Bam still says he does not want to sign with us, which is pretty sad. So he said he's ready for his time with the Sonics to come to an end, even though it says he's extremely loyal, which is really weird. I hate how that thing always changed with everyone. Jalen Brown's somewhat loyal, but everyone else, it seems like we either had them, like Thibault, he says he doesn't want to sign with the Sonics, but that's too bad, because guess what? We have our team option with him, so doesn't really matter. So I guess we can just go to the draft. I already did some staff signing stuff, so I already signed all my staff last season, so we're good on that. I don't even really know who's in this year's NBA draft. So let's take a look and see. Yeah, obviously I'm not really going to know any of these guys, because I'm not really into, these guys would be either seniors in high school or, you know, players in the college hoop game that I don't really know. So let's just go to the draft and kind of just see what's going on here. Who can we trade? We can trade Willie. I've always said we really only signed Willie just to keep for our keepsake, for a tradable contract to get a potential starting center later on in the series, because I made Bam a power forward. And if Bam doesn't re-sign with us, I'm going to be very, 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 very upset, because he was sort of our first big pick from you guys that you guys wanted to see stay on the team. So I'm going to make some trades happen, and then I will come back to you guys probably after the draft. Alrighty, so I traded our pick this year and our next year's pick, because I'm predicting we're probably going to be either high seeded or at least better than we did last season, because of our horrible start. And I traded it for the 11th pick, so I picked. I traded our pick this year and next year for an 11th pick this year. I'm not sure what we really need. Let's go to. I think we need a backup point guard. Yeah, we're gonna need a backup point guard for sure. Center, I think we're gonna be good. Or center, actually, because Daniel's probably going to want a big contract, because he's an 80 overall. I'm not going to want to pay him that much. And then we still have Thibault. Okay, yeah, so let's pick up a point guard. Ooh, I think this guy's a shooting guard. 6'5". Leonardo Barbosa. Not really what I'm looking for. I mean, I guess we could just make him a point guard if we really wanted to. Only ranked 16th. That's not good at all. And he's already 20. Yeah, I'm not sure that's really the move. How about I just get the guy with the best ranking? So I'm guessing it's going to be Scotty Lewis, because. Or this guy. This guy has 13. And he's a B+ overall. B minus C plus. This guy seems to have more badges, and that's might be a indication that he might be a pretty good player. So let's pick up this guy and see what overall he is. He's only a 75. Oh no. I think I might have just messed up there. I think, let's see who other point guards were there. Cade Cunningham was the only really other point guard that was pretty high drafted. So I think we did pretty good there. And I'm not going to trade anyone else, I don't think. So that's not that bad. I'll just trade him on later. Okay, Thibault, we're keeping on. Allen, we're going to trade, because he actually has some pretty good potential now. Luka Doncic is a 99 now. Oh my god. Oh, Kawhi's a free agent. I tried to find some, like, notable names for this next episode, because I forgot to show them my last episode. So, for free agents, you guys didn't really get a chance to see. apologize for that. For that, I've totally flaked and forgot about that because I was filming that video for like 2 hours. Honestly, it took so long. But okay, so there's Kawhi, and oh my god, 16. Oh my god, a 4-year. Oh my god, that's so much money, dude. I mean, obviously we can offer him the max, but I don't want to max out a player. You guys know I am very much a cheapskate when it comes to these videos. I like good contracts. I might just match whatever anyone gives them, and because obviously I can offer them more, because they're offering a 4-year 124. Oh my god, so much money. That's $27 million this next season, and then it goes up from that. I wonder if you'll accept it if I do like a front flat, like 27. Let's do 27 flat. Let's see if he'll accept this. Because that's not that bad. Okay, wow, it's not even his top 4. It's not top 3 at all. Dang it, yeah, because I really don't want to do all that. I mean, I don't really expect this to go longer than probably 3 more episodes, so. Because I usually get pretty good at these rebuilds. Not gonna lie, I get pretty lucky. But I said before in my last video, who some of the free agents were, and you guys really liked the idea of getting Taco Fall. And he should be right here. He wants, because we do need a backup center. So good looking out. So obviously, and Taco Fall is just a goat. Bobo would be really cool too. But he wants a freaking $20 million. Oh, he's at 82 overall now. Jeez, wow. He was probably in the G League or something. But we're gonna go with Taco Fall. Hopefully he develops a little bit for next season. So I'm gonna offer him like a 3-year. Actually, I'll offer him a 4-year, 750 flat. That's a pretty good one. I never want to pay like anyone over like 10 mil coming off the bench. Bench. That's sort of my rule. Now, and we need a backup point guard, so we're gonna trade Wendell or Shake for a backup point guard. So let's see what we can get for these guys here. I'm assuming Shake's probably gonna have more. Actually, we can just see who has more trade value, and it's Wendell by a whole star. So let's see what Wendell. Oh my god, we can just get Chris Middleton. I would do that, but I'm not trying to win this year. I want to do at least 2 more episodes, then I'll start getting really drastic with my picks on trades and whatnot. JD McDaniels. Why we need a point guard? I keep getting sidetracked. Okay, Keenan Allen is a free agent next season. That's not really what I really want. I want like more of like either a young player. Afrin's, yeah, gonna be a free agent. This Tyrese Maxey guy's only 6'3". I wonder how good his ball handling and stuff is. His per 36 is really good. He's not really much of a passer though. I don't really like that at all. Playmaking B minus. Yeah, this guy's more of a scoring one. I might have to make my own trade here, so I'll come back with you guys when I make a trade for a point guard. Alright, so it's a little bit further in the future than I thought it was gonna be. My neighbor upstairs, yes, the famous neighbor upstairs, started doing laundry, so it was very loud. But I did make a trade. I traded Wendell Moore Jr. Into second round picks for Nico Mannen from Arizona. He actually played pretty good for them for the Bulls last season, but he still is on a great contract, 77 overall. You know, pretty good. Played pretty good for them last season. Shot almost 50%. Rest of I guess if we needed a backup small forward, we could just take him and put him as a small forward. But let's just simulate right now and just see and hope if we can get Taco Fall. And bam. Okay, so he's going to sign a contract with the Celtics. We're going to match it no matter what. And then we also have Taco. So that's not too bad. We're declining those guys. Just see how this goes with Taco getting minutes, because I obviously want to get Taco in the game, because dude's 7'5", got a pretty jump shot and everything. So his per 36 is 10 and almost 15 with two blocks. That's crazy. So we're gonna leave that there and then just just sort of see how this goes. So, also, by the way, I'm very sorry that it's very loud right now in my area. But, yeah. Anyways, so I think we're gonna also put, yeah, probably Nico. No offense to Taco, but I feel like Nico's probably gonna be a better, having a backup point guard is very important, I feel like, in the NBA. Player can run your team when your starter is not in the game. I also do not pre-record these videos because I like to talk a little bit of up-to-date basketball with you guys. And as I'm recording this, oh my god, wow. Okay, well, first of all, let's go over here. My league all-star simulate difficulty is 50. Just to make sure you guys know I'm not doing anything weird, but wow, we are killing the game right now. Beating the Pelicans by... Actually, we beat the Kings by more, didn't we? Yeah, 25. Look at that, 36 by Jaylen Brown. Cole Anthony's doing good, look at that. See, bam, all you needed to do was give us a chance, bam. That's all you needed to do, was give us a chance. And look at that, 16 points. Man's averaging 19 points, 11 rebounds, beautiful. He's actually shooting the three a little bit more. His free throw percentage is insane. Wow, very good improvement there. Denny, Nico, all doing awesome. If Willie Cauley-Stein can average a double-double this season, that'd be a big plus for us. Taco, not really doing much. He's only averaging 2 points and 5 rebounds, but hey, I mean, I think having a good big rotation would be very important for us. No offense to Jetty, but I think having big men down there would be a lot easier for us. Even though Willie Cauley-Stein and Taco Fall are really defensive-minded bigs. I'm going to decline that. What was I saying? But yeah, today, as I'm recording this video, the Blazers play the Suns. And hopefully the Blazers lose. I think they actually won that game, or are winning the game right now. So I'm hoping for a Blazer tank. This is Kyrie Rookie. This guy has 3 years left on his contract, and he's a 78 overall. Dang. He's 6'6". Is he like a just 8 points, 10 points? Which is 3-point shooting. It's actually really good. Oh, man. Yo, this might be a good trade because then we'd get this guy for an extra season. I really like this, actually, because Thybul is definitely leaving after the 2022 season, and I don't think we'll win a championship then yet. I think 2023 is our year. I think next season I'll maybe try and trade for a big, you know, another impactful star. So I think having a guard by then will be good. Oh man. Plus this dude is definitely 13, 14. They're very similar, actually. Two steals, one steal. Oh man. You know what, guys? I think I'm gonna do it. Plus, his contract is even cheaper. It'll save us like $2 million. You know what? Thybul, I appreciate all you've done for us last season. You helped us out so much. And I appreciate all you've done. You're basically 85 overall now. You deserve to get that starter's contract that I'm not going to give you. I think it's time to move on to a different guy who has an A perimeter defense just like you, an A 3-point shot just like you, but on a better contract. So, Thybul, thank you so much for what you've done. So, alright, first trade of the season. Wow. Everybody on the team is hot. That's really good. Like I said before, I don't think we're going to win the championship this season. I think we'll have some playoff success, which is awesome. Awesome. Wow, this Denny guy actually wants a lot of minutes. I'm pretty surprised. Wait, who's not in the rotation right now? The new guy. Okay, well, I want to make the new guy happy. So, Jetty, again, I'm so sorry, but... Get 21. I want Bam to get a little bit more trade didn't really mess up our team chemistry at all. Rui Hachimura, oh man, is he still on a really good contract? Grizzlies lost again tonight, which I think they lost like 3 or 4 in a row now. So, the Pelicans, 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 Pelicans. Everyone wants to see the Pelicans in the playoffs. Milton for Ross. No, but I do need to trade Shake at some point in this video. How is the team doing so well? Oh my god, dude, I swear. Again, no cuts, no nothing, no cuts, no editing. Boom. It's still 50. It's still All-Star. I don't know if that does anything. I think it's just like still at 50. Not doing anything. I mean, if we win the championship this season, then this is the end of the series. Unless I try and do like a repeat or something, but these, like I said before, the second episode didn't really get that many, that much love. So I might just finish out and just play one season. So, which isn't bad. Like I'm saying, it's not, it is probably full. It happens with every series. Last last season, but having Luke Walton there is pretty rough. I'm not a big fan of, I don't want to say a big fan of him, but not really a big fan of what he does as a coach. Okay, so our team is doing extremely well right now. Sorry about the glare. Let's see if I can fix that. There we go. 42-7. Bam is at a 95 overall. Oh my god. Jeez. Averaging 17 points, 10 rebounds, a block a game. Field goal percentage is a little low, but it's still about 50. His free throw percentage went down a lot, but it's still around his average. Jaylen Brown. Oh my god. Yo, that's why I titled my last video, the trade that saves us, because Jaylen Brown's averaging 30 points per game. 6 rebounds, 3 assists, a steal. That is crazy. Almost 60% field goal percentage, almost 50% three-point percentage, almost 80 free throw. I don't know why they're playing them at such a high rate at 36 minutes. He's not. Apparently, Bam is actually supposed to have more minutes, but he's plus minus is plus 14. Oh my god. That is insane. And then this Allen guy, who's coming off the bench, is actually our third highest rating player according to 2K. Just averaging basically a double-double. I might have to give him more minutes, actually. I didn't even know this guy was gonna. I don't even know what this is. Is this a real player? Drafted in 2019. Apparently he is. No offense, but I don't know who this guy is, but he's developing very well and very fast. We have our boy Denny here, averaging very good numbers with a very good shooting percentage. Love that. 11 plus minus. What is this guy's plus minus? Plus 7. Okay, that's not that bad. We got Jetty, who apparently, yeah, I haven't even played him at all this season. He's our top 5 highest rated player. Actually, all of our guys are kind of in the same range because, if you don't remember in the first episode, we did a player draft, an expansion draft, so all these players are kind of tiered up in the same little area of overalls. We have Cole, who's been improving. That's awesome. Almost 20-10, dude. I love that. Shooting percentage is awesome. 13 plus minus. And his backup, Nico, putting up the same numbers basically as he did last year. I think, yeah, he had a little bit more minutes last season. But his plus minus is 6, which is obviously more than he did last season, not being on that great of a team. And then we have Willie Cauley-Stein. I think this is definitely the season we trade Willie Cauley-Stein. Let's see how good his defense has been. I wish it was like a defensive rating or something like that I could look at. There probably is, but I don't really know where it is. But, you know, almost a block, not even double-double in rebounds and points, so not really where I want him to be. He's actually shooting three-pointers, which, what the heck? Why is he doing that? I have no idea. I'm surprised. Yeah, his morale's not even that good right now, so that's kind of annoying. And then, Devin is probably not mad. I mean, not happy with us not getting a lot of minutes. Actually, he's doing pretty good with the minutes he's getting. He's almost 80 overall. And then Taco, been kind of a disappointment, not gonna lie. 3 points, 4 rebounds, but I think Taco's just here to get the chip. So I think Taco's probably the player who's gonna stay around because this 7'5" man is super cool, and I feel like he deserves a championship. And then we have Beaumont and Moore, who's not playing at all. But okay, so I'm gonna try and find a trade for Willie Cauley-Stein, and let's see if I can find anything good for us. Okay, so as I was looking through the trade finder for Willie Cauley-Stein, I couldn't really find anything, but I did remember that this upcoming free agency has loads of unrestricted or probably restricted free agents. But I can make offers to all of these guys because we actually have some cap room next season. But having Yusuf Nurkic next season would be awesome. Marvin Bagley, Mo Bamba, Wendell Carter Jr., Jared Allen, Rashard Holmes, Jackson Hayes. Oh, actually, no, I can't with them. Harry Giles would be a good one. Anyone else that really pops up? Not really. But yeah, those top guys, I would love to have Yusuf Nurkic. I would love that. He's probably going to get re-signed by Portland, but if I can somehow snag Yusuf Nurkic this next offseason, I would love that so much. Or even Mitchell Robinson. I think Aiden will probably get re-signed, obviously, and even Bagley probably will too. as well. Our window, he's a minus two right now, so it's not like he's very happy with this team. Or even Jared Allen, probably not liking too much sharing minutes with DeAndre Jordan. So, I think I'm just going to sit on Willie Cauley-Stein, and if we have a good chance of getting a center, I'm going to trade him, free up cap, and then sign a good center next season. So, this was definitely going to be my first big question that you guys should comment down below. What center should I go after? Ayton's going to be kind of hard, but there's Ayton, Mr. Robinson, Yusuf Nurkic, Jonas Valanciunas, Marvin Bagley, Mo Bamba, Wendell Carter Jr., Jarrett Allen, Rashard Holmes, Jackson, that's about it. Harry Giles, or even any power forwards I can turn into. I mean, there's Jarrett Jackson Jr., I could make us a center. That is probably going to be about it. Okay, so yeah, there's some good centers out there, so make sure to comment down below what center I should go after in free agency this next season, because that's really all we're missing is a center, because our point guard position is good. We got two lockdown defending shooting threes, or pretty good playmaking. We got Jaylen Brown balling out of his mind. Pretty good small forward rotation right there. Power forward's locked down with Bam. All we need is a good center, and then we have Willie Cauley, Taco Fall, big body down there. We can hopefully develop into a good defensive-minded player. So that's all we need to do. So hopefully that works out. So I think I'm going to sit on this team right now. Hopefully have a pretty decent playoff run, maybe the conference finals, maybe that'd be awesome. But anything past that is definitely better than I thought we were going to be. And this is definitely the best I thought we were going to be, a fifth seed playoff contender, but right now you can see we are actually we're actually the one seed. I don't know. I keep showing you guys the simulating difficulty without editing and anything like that, so I'm so surprised that this is actually happening. Louisville is still sucking, but the Clippers, oh my god. Oh, that's right, they don't have Kawhi anymore. Where's Kawhi? Oh yeah, Kawhi's on the Raptors. Yeah, Kawhi's on the Raptors, but he's not doing so hot, so that's pretty surprising. The Pelicans are the 2 seed with their rookie they just drafted. I think they don't have Lonzo anymore, which is kind of sad, but we know Brandon Ingram, Zion, they have James Wiseman too. Oh my god. Jackson Hayes, they have Schroeder off the bench and Hayward off the bench. Drew Holiday off the bench. Dude, this team's deep. This team might be a title contender. The Wolves with Obi Toppin, Russell, and Towns. The Lakers still, LeBron AD. And Steven Adams. Wow, that's a good team. The Mavericks with 98, 90, 90, 90, 98 overall. Luka, Mike Conley. Wow, Porzingis. Still have Seth, Derek Jones Jr. And then Portland with Dame, Victor. Nas at the 4. That's kind of crazy. And then Yusuf. This team is so good. Jordan Bell. Oh my god. I know Jordan Bell is a free agent right now. I wish Portland would give this guy a contract, because we need more bigs. We need a 4. Because next season, I doubt Carmelo's going to re-sign with us or anything like that. So I think having Jordan Bell next season would be awesome for Portland. Then you have Denver, Memphis, the Rockets, the Warriors aren't doing so hot. They definitely need to trade Wiggins, but why is this team so bad? They have Clay, Curry, Wiggins, and Clint Capella with D. Smith off the bench. That's crazy. And then everyone else is kind of in that same boat. And then Philly's also below 500. They have Ben and Rodney. And they have this, oh my god, look at this rotation, bro. That is a deadly big man rotation. I feel like the Sixers always have a really good big man rotation. So, yeah, I think I'm just going to simulate the rest of the season, and I will show you guys where we stack up in the rankings and playoff race. And we are coming up to the end of the season. I did make one trade while I was gone. Sorry. I totally forgot we still had a trade. Shake, 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 Milton. And we did do
See how it goes. Thibault.
Tingles. I was actually hoping we could win a championship, but all I can offer this next season is just getting the center. All we need is the center. That's it. And I think we can win a championship next season, or at least make the finals. Because, yeah, honestly, our barely an 80 backup center who didn't really even do much when he did have playing time. You know, 3 points per game. Come on. Like, I think we just need a better center, and I think we're good to go. So, I guess we could check out the draft lottery. Anyone retired? Iggy, Trevor Ariza, Paul Millsap, Luol Deng, JR, Wesley Matthews, some notable names. I guess we can see where our draft pick goes. Probably just gonna mute the TV because I hate that little ticky 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 noise. Okay. Honestly, any trade right now, I mean, I'm so surprised that the Rockets didn't make it. I'm surprised they didn't make the playoffs. I'm surprised they are the worst team in the league. What the heck happened? That doesn't make any sense. Because when I traded for that pick, it was like a 2.5 star. And then I traded, obviously, you know, Shake Milton. It was, I think, a 2.5 for like a 3-star. So it was like a pretty easy trade-off. But now, I mean, this trade is going to be worth a lot. Honestly, we could just trade that pick for a center. Unless there's a good, like a really good center in this draft, which I don't think there is one. But, wow, we got really lucky there. That's pretty insane. With the Rockets right there. Then again, 2K probably doesn't notice, like, obviously they probably don't have a center, so it's probably not going to be that great of a 2K team, because 2K loves centers and loves having equal teams and stuff like that, so. Okay, so now we have the Kings. I don't think we're going to get the number one pick, there's no way. I think we'll get top five, hopefully. Pick 7, so the Bulls are top 4 now. Bulls with the 6th pick. Comes Atlanta. Okay, so Utah, so Atlanta's not top 4 now. I think, right? Isn't that what it means? Okay, so Bulls have the 4th pick. Wait, the Bulls have 2 picks? Oh, they have the Golden State Warriors pick. Oh my god, the Bulls, man. Yikes. Please be Atlanta, 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 Atlanta. Oh, okay, well, we get the 3rd pick. That's not bad at all. I think we're obviously going to have to trade that pick. There's no way we're keeping it, right? I think we're starting to have to go in for the championship run here. Wow. The Bulls get pick 7 and, 6 and 4. That's crazy. Oh wait, the Hawks have 2 picks too. They have the OKC pick. Oh my god. Yo, I know ASMR like the play is quivering in excitement. Having back-to-back pick 1 and pick 2, that's so stupid. And then us, and then the Bulls, and the Jazz, and then the Bulls again. That's crazy, yo. Atlanta gets some good picks there. Dang, okay, well, I'm going to show you guys the value of our true pick, and you guys can figure out what we should do with it. Like I said, we do need a center, but I think in free agency is where we get our center. We can get CJ coming off the bench for a championship run. Russell Westbrook. Yo, I think the Houston Rockets are blowing up their team. We can get Russell Westbrook. That's crazy. Russell Westbrook had a pretty decent season. Nothing too unusual. He had a better shooting season than he did last season. He only played 30 minutes a game. -2. +/-. Wow. That team was just bad. That was just a bad team they had last season, bro. But we can get Russell. That's insane. We can get Sabonis. Honestly, we could probably play Sabonis at center. 6'11", or we can put Bam at center, so I think Sabonis is definitely an option for us. So make sure to comment down below what we should do with this pick. We can get De'Aaron Fox. Oh my god. De'Aaron Fox for a championship run. so much again for watching this video, giving it support. If you are giving it support, I love you for that, because I love this series. I love this team. I love interacting with you guys, and make sure to comment down below what we should do with this pick. If we should trade it for Rudy Gobert, or, you know, Russell Westbrook, or De'Aaron Fox, that'd be pretty cool. And then what center we should go after in free agency. That's probably the two things I really want to know. And then I'm hopefully going to build a championship contending team with what we do with those picks in free agency. So I think next season is our season. We only lost because of LeBron. I think LeBron, another year in, hopefully is degrading a little bit faster than usual. So, and hopefully that Laker team doesn't have any cap space, so maybe we can hopefully get some wiggle room with what to do. So, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will see you again in my next video very, 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 very soon. All right, guys.